I didn't hit him. I pulled back on the leg. I should have hit him, but I'm a sportsman. I'm not that kind of fighter. He lays down. What the man's doing is laying down and trying to get out of this fight gracefully.
To this day, both fighters disagree on what happened. Both predict a different outcome this time.
I think that his style that gave me problems was he was able to manipulate the judges, and that he threw a lot of flurry techniques, and he was able to influence the judges by throwing a lot of crazy techniques, and the judges wasn't looking very carefully at what he was doing. The guy was not scoring at me. The guy caused me no problems whatsoever. Tony Paramore is not in my class. The guy didn't hit me, and he claimed I kicked him low. The real problem was I kicked so hard, Tony Paramore thought I kicked him low, because I can kick you in the head and you fit him in the toenail.
It was a 4-hour flight from Memphis, Tennessee to Nairobi, Kenya. I smiled and I saw my friend Thomas Mungi and his little boy Simba. I was so anxious to get out of the airport and just to come to Kenya to introduce kickboxing to the country of Kenya.
Good morning. I'd like, on behalf of Sarova Hotels, the management and the directors, to welcome the champ.
Nairobi City Council, His Worship the Mayor, the councillors and the people of Nairobi, I'm proud that you have chosen Nairobi City to be the venue of the world title fight in July. On behalf of His Worship the Mayor, the councillors of the Nairobi City Council, I wish to welcome you to Nairobi.
So I'm here to introduce my sport of exciting karate kickboxing, and I hope, or what my goal is to achieve, is to benefit the African country by bringing the Africans and the African Americans to place with.
Now you can get in. think you're going to win this one?
Speaker, today I rise to applaud the efforts of Ghana in promoting good governance and civic participation. President Obama will wrap up the third leg of his international trip in Ghana. He'll be there today, and I'm reminded of the important role this democratic nation plays in the international world. Ghana is an active participant in the United Nations and the African Union, and its region has been extremely active in international peacekeeping. Ghana, the first state in sub-Saharan Africa to gain its independence, has shown that it's a stable nation whose government and people are accountable to one another. These acts are a good first step in developing future relationships between our nation and Ghana. One of my constituents, five-time karate and kickboxing champion Anthony Amp Elmore, fulfilled his lifelong dream by visiting Ghana in 1998. The champ visited Accra and it's changed life. After returning to Memphis, Amp developed his vision of educating and enlightening people about the cultural and economic importance of Africa as a continent, as well as Ghana. At his home and throughout the city, he showcased African artifacts, fabrics, and art. This weekend, on Friday and Saturday both, he'll be honoring Africa at his home and inviting the public and having a fashion show and an African dinner. I'll be there.
We need each other. Wake up, everybody. Well, you see, we need, wake up, everybody. We
come
need,
on now, wake up, everybody. No more sleeping in bed. No more backward thinking. Time for thinking ahead. A new way. They're the ones that suffer each and every day. Teach the children,
teach the baby,
teach the babies,
teach the children,
teach the children,
teach the babies,
teach the children,
teach the babies.
They're the one who's coming out.
James Brown's I'm Black and I'm Proud was an affirmation of self-respect. And it was a challenge to others to respect themselves and to respect him.
Brother, we can't quit until we get our share.
Everybody was trying to think of what to say about Martin Luther King getting shot, about the situation in America, the civil rights movement. Everybody just wanted to know how to capitalize it. And so when James Brown said, say it loud, I'm black and I'm proud, that said it. That's it. So when he said it, everybody hollered back, I'm black and I'm proud.
The words were magical. I mean, that was the ultimate emancipation.
Every crisis is an opportunity, and he's one of the few people that took the crisis of 1968 and turned it into an opportunity to really help a generation of people.